All right, today we're going to talk about field data, whether you call it punch walks, field inspections, site visits, site walks, as-builts, pre-construction walkthroughs. Collecting field data is what we're going to go through today. So first off, I want to show you guys how to place these symbols. So over in our tool chest over here, Bluebeam has some of these out of the box. If you look on their website, you can also download some that are pre-built, and you're just going to select it and go ahead and go out into the sheet and place it. So these are nice. You can place them wherever they need to be. They're nice and small so they can fit. Chances are you don't know what these mean just yet. So what I want to show you guys here is if you click on the little gear and click on detail, you're actually going to see the subject of that markup and then the comment that's built into it. Until you know what these mean, you can have it in detail view and then go back to symbol once you recognize what those mean. So you can go ahead and place those wherever need be. I'm just placing them random. And then if you need to create a custom one, you can very easily just make a copy. Again, the trick to make a copy of something is just select it, hold your control key down on your keyboard, click and drag, and then let go, and it'll make a copy wherever you dropped it off. Okay, so all this is a group of markups. If I hold my Alt key down, it'll highlight each piece of that group, and I can double click and modify that text. So I'm gonna say TR. And with that still selected, I'm gonna go over to my properties, the little gearbox over here, and I'm gonna call it tile repair. And then down in the comments, I can write down what needs to be done or what I saw. So I'm gonna say broken tile. Grout. Okay, so now that's embedded into that markup. Now all I need to do is right click on it, go down to add to tool chest, and put it in that tool set. So click on there, and now you can see that in my tool set. And when I click on the properties again and go to detail view, then you'll see tile repair, broken tile, and grout in my tool. So that's how you can create those on the fly. But you're probably thinking, what am I going to do when I have a bunch of them and I need to create a bunch of these? I don't want to make copies, double click, modify all that information. So what I want to show you here is how to create a new tool set. We'll start with that, a new tool set, and then we're going to import an Excel file with all of those symbols that we want to create. Okay, so first off, let's go up to the tool chest, go down to manage tool sets. And I'm going to click on add, and I'm just going to name this one punch just for the course today. I'm going to say okay. I'm going to go ahead and save that in the default location, and now you can see I've got an empty tool set over here. Okay, the next thing that we want to do is go into the tool set manager again, select that tool set, and click on modify. And now what we want to do, I'm going to show you the Excel file first. Open that. You can see I've got the subject in here is going to be column A. That's going to show up in the subject over here. Column B is the symbol text. So that's what's going to show up in this circle. And it's a circle by default. So it's going to end up in that circle. And then column C is the comments that are going to show up here. Okay. So we can import that very quickly and create all these symbols in one step. First, I'm going to go ahead and delete this row. Otherwise, it's going to create a symbol that says symbol subject comment. So I'm going to delete this one. Okay, and then I'm just going to save it. And I need to save it as a CSV. You have to make sure that it's a CSV file. Okay, now we can come into this modify tool set window, click on punch key import, and we're going to go out and find that Excel file where I have it. and that's our punch list, CSV, and I'm going to say open. And that's going to load all of those tools. So now you can see them in the list here, the subject and comments. You can also see over here that they've been added to my tool set that I assigned them to. So now I can go ahead and click OK and OK here. And again, we can click on the gearbox here and go to detail view, and it will show you what each one of those mean. So that's how you can quickly create these punch symbols. Quickly, I'm just going to show you how we can add images to these symbols as well. This one here, I'm going to come down here and just select this one. And if you right click on it, you can go down to capture. If you're in the field on an iPad or a Surface Pro, you can use from camera and actually take a picture directly into the markup or a video. I'm just going to go from file, go ahead and navigate out to where my images are. And I can go and select, let's see if I can find a good one. That one's a good one. We'll say okay. And now that placed an image into that symbol. It gave me a little icon here. When I click that, it's going to open up the flipbook, and then you can see the image that's associated with that markup. Okay, so the water's flowing over the sink. So that's how you can very quickly add images and videos to your markups. I hope you liked the video today. Go ahead and like, subscribe, and get ready for the next one.